Hello, good evening. Good evening. Can you turn to someone? It's a celebration of Felix Dexter's life. There are people still coming. We apologise for the late delay. It's the performers. We apologise. Performers are stuck in traffic. Can you please turn to someone? This is my... 1 minute, 1 minute. Felix, I told you they're blasted ungrateful. Yeah. I hear you, my brother. Can you turn to someone who you don't know and say hello? Wave if you have to. Let's create the atmosphere. It's a celebration of Felix Dexter's life. You'll be up singing, dancing and whatever, and uprisers, come on. We're here tonight because we want to build a theatre for Felix Dexter in his native St. Kitts, where he comes from. Do we have any conditions in the house? Make some noise. We had heard that everybody had left to come here. We used to have, you know, the Catitian flag has two stars. You know, we do, because it's St. Kitts, the two stars, those don't know, it's St. Kitts and Nevis, the two. But we didn't want to cause no problems with the two stars, because when I was in St. Kitts last year, there was a little bit of snobbery going on. Snobbery. Like, for example, Catitians, I said, I'm going across to Nevis. Why are you going there for? When I got to Nevis, I'm staying in St. Kitts. Why are you staying there for? So you would think there would be this great love. It's 20 minutes by boat. And I went across for the 20 minutes, and this guy was giving me a story, and I felt my whole life had changed. This man was saying, oh, English boy, everything is different here in St. Kitts. Fantastic. And you know, if you're born in this country, it's almost like when you go into obscure parts of the Caribbean or Africa. When someone in St. Kitts is talking, they're talking really fast, and you don't know what they're saying, you don't want to be rude and say, excuse me, please come again. This guy was like, why is that boy in his St. Kitts? I was finding out what I just saw jump in and everything was great. Who's he talking to? So I want to say, okay, so where are we now? So I don't know if you've been watching the internet, you've been watching the news and stuff, but there's this craze going on. I mean, if you look around us, we are one big family. There's this craze called Killer Clown, where people are jumping out and scaring. I don't know if you know about this. People are jumping out and scaring people, frightening people, dressing up as some clown. They have chainsaws and blah, 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 terrifying people. Let me explain something about why that's not going to work with Jeff Schuman. Let me tell you something. Let me explain something. You see something now? You see this now? You can scare who you want for skier. You can jump out on who you want jump out. But if I lick you with this, no one ain't taking me to court because you troubled me. You came after me. It reminds me of those stupid chain letters. We were told 2 weeks ago that WhatsApp and Facebook are in some sort of conspiracy. And if you don't do this, people can read your messages. Shut up! You've got nothing better to do. For the last 6 years, if I don't send 100 people this message, WhatsApp are going to start charging me. You know, what we need something like, if you don't send this to 50 people, someone's going to burgle your yard. Who are these people who send out these stupid chain messages? And black people get excited. They want to be the first. Yeah, Beanie Man's dead. Me, see, see. Beanie Man had to put up. Beanie Man put up a thing on Facebook himself saying that no, I'm fine. And most black people, well, boy, I saw me did here. You know, let me show you how this thing works. How wicked people can be. I went to this audition. I'm currently in a new program called Papa Doms. It's a sitcom thing for ITV. And it's funny that when white people haven't seen me for a long time, they've got a different reaction. Oh, it's a hearsay. What's the white guy to me? Jeff Schuman? Cool, you ain't half done well. You're half the bloody size. Well done. Black people different. Black people ain't seen me. Me is MC. Black people. Virus. Yeah man. Me and send up one of them operation thing, them, you know, saying them gastric thing, you know. If I had one of them things inside of me, I'd have eaten that already. Ladies and gents, I have a superb co-host with me this evening. Remember, for every act that comes out on stage tonight, you got to show them some love, some appreciation, and make some noise. I just want to see who's in the house on each side of the room, because my co-host is absolutely going to drive you mad. On this side, on the count of three, if you can make as much noise as possible, because it's a celebration about Phoenix, some of you are going to get up and start dancing and shaking your leg and whatever. On the count of three, make some noise. One, two, three! Okay, okay, Simon Cowell's not here. Calm down, man. Some black people just get excited. It's cool, man. On this side, on the count of three, can you make some noise? One, two, three! Everybody together! Ladies and gents, can you please make some noise for my co-host, the world-renowned, the world-famous, make some noise for Dibby!
But killing me, you know, ain't young like he used to be, you know, so I had to take in. You know what I mean? Oh, Lord, like the other day, tried to get up off the settee. And you know, like the pain talking to me. I get up and I feel the pain draw me back. And you know, you've got to make a move again till you brush it off. Hear the pain.
What about Santiago? Then you never feel me the first time. Idiot.
Then you try again. You just rush it up. So
you are end up in a hospital. Go on again.
How y'all doing? White people, make some noise. Try again. White people, make some noise. That's better. Get them a drink. They sound louder than one of them. Let me see you in here. Patrons! Talk up, patrons. I might frig with the Jamaicans later. And I might need a hand to get out of her. Sit notions! Sacrifice doo-doo. Dominicans! African! Nigerian! Ghanaian! Guyanese!
Maybe everybody's here from St. Kitts tonight. Everybody.
It looks like the island empty.
Hey! Look, you forgot. You've been disrespectful. Is there anybody here from Nevis in the missions? Anybody here from Nevis?
That's part of St. Kitts.
They're one thing, but they're separated by water.
Separated by water?
Yes, sir.
Anyone here from who? Nevia?
Nevis.
Anyone here from Nevia?
Nevis!
Move, look, see her there? Look go along, go along. See, kids and kidnap your shite later, you carry on. Yeah, where they, that was. Check talking about this clown business online. Out of heart, ain't it? You do the right thing with the back, Jeff.
I'm not playing with them.
Don't play with them.
I'm saying that. No, you know, like, if someone breaks into your house, if you use unnecessary force, the police will prosecute you, not me. I will beat them like they're my first you, and then no one. And I'm like, sorry. I don't need social workers in here.
You gotta be careful.
Be careful. You know,
and you know, look, they're swimming.
My mom always said to me, my mom said, social workers are spoiling black kids by telling parents they can't beat their children.
Bastards!
My mom says, bring me a social worker, and I'll beat the social worker in front of you.
Bastards!
Again, too.
That's right.
Ladies and gents, are you ready for a night to celebrate the life of the late great Felix Dexter?
When I say Felix, you say Dexter.
Felix! Felix! Felix!
Oh, Lord!
Oh, my God.
Right, hey, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to bring on the first act now, Jeff.
Absolutely.
It look good, ain't it, girls? Yeah. It look good. You know me and Jeff had it for a long time. And I said to Jeff, Jeff, come, I will walk you, I will make you lose that weight. You lose that weight, baby.
Do you know something? This, whatever this creature is, must pray that she never goes to prison. Because them man will be doing a lottery right now, waiting for you to come see it. You see this bat? You'll see it in more ways than one.
I just got to say this. Jeff talked about when he go to the gym. I think Jim has come to your house.
You're sick. You're sick.
Sorry, Jeff.
You said that and missed it. I'm not bitter.
Sorry.
So ladies and gents, our first performer tonight, sensational and magnificent performer, top comic, a great friend of Felix's. They shared part of their parental lineage from the Isle of the Saint Kitts. So ladies and gents, will you please put your hands together for the magnificent, for the wonderful, make some noise for Mr. C! Come on!
Respect, man. Give it up to Jeff, please, and the other thing there. And Dibby, my original baby mother. So. You're laughing, you want to see the child. It's a beautiful little girl. I call her Shabba Glover, because she looks like Shabba and Danny Glover. How you doing, people? Nice one, man. I just want to have a good look around, first of all, before I start. Just want to make sure that none of my work friends them is here. Because, like, I've been off work sick for a little while. United go already, come on. United go, when you're not well, you have to kind of... Because, like, work, come on, let's be honest. A lot of us, we're this close to thumping our supervisor. No, but you know what? It's even more dangerous during October, because like it's Black History Month. And sometimes what happens, we enjoy ourselves too much over the weekend being black, and we forget during the hours of 9 to 5, Monday to Friday, you can't be black at work. We get a disciplinary warning for that. But your supervisor don't realize just how close they are to a black thumping. Come ask me stupid question by why am I late? I tell them, say, I see winter start. We're not going, man. Stupidness, man. Stupidness. Like, we've got a guy at my workplace, right? He's always, always sick. And what happened is, because when they want to try and get hold of him, they can't because he ain't got no phone, he ain't got no landline in his yard. So what happened, they bought him a mobile phone for the sole purpose that when he's off sick, they can phone him up and ask him when their ass is coming back into work. But because he's so black and everything, yeah, he dealt with it in such a black way, he put the phone on divert back to the office. Yeah, right about now, you call yourself. Beautiful thing, man, when you're black, it's a beautiful thing, man. Now, there's times when it's, you know, when the blackness just overwhelms you, and there's times when being black can be dangerous, isn't it? Like, you just can't enjoy certain things in life, like other cultures. Like, you know, if you're a black male driving, can be dangerous if you're a black man, isn't it? Sometimes it's a different pressure. When you see the blue lights, you know, your heart starts boom, boom, boom. And you know, you ain't done nothing wrong, but you know that you're just not boo, boo. And you look at your mum and you say, why, police behind? And then your mum start hide the Bible and everything. And you're like, mum, what are you doing? She said, we're not taking no chances. So, you know, it's all good, man. I enjoy the fact that we've come out here tonight for Felix, man, because, like, a lot of you don't realise that, like, my mum, it's from Felix's island, St. Kitts. And so now that Felix is gone, it's like I'm the only kind of petition comedian left. See, it's not impressive, is it? Jamaica's like, yeah, I'm so. Not for we about, not for we about. We even got a white one now. But I gotta say that, you know what? I think like Felix was a special guy because his mother was a special person. And the same with like me, it's like my mum taught me the values of comedy, you know what I'm saying? Taught me the values of comedy. It's like the first time I asked her for money and everything. I never seen my mum laugh like that in all my life. All my life. She said, yes, your name on the benefit book. But it's only me can cash it. Beautiful, man. Beautiful. I've got three sons as well. I've got that Cotician heritage and that Jamaican heritage. And because they've got that black heritage, because they're my boys, it's like we take this special thing that we have as black people and we take it into the environment with us, you know what I mean? Because it's beautiful, the blackness. So like, come sports day, it's a beautiful thing when I watch my sons doing sports with their blackness, because it's not sport for us, is it? You know what I mean? Because we know our children are going to win that. Because it's a black thing, don't it? It's not sport for us, you know what I mean? Because we've been through 400 years of slavery, now mental slavery. So when we do sports, yeah, it's about winning for us, you understand? Because my father taught me about that. My father, sports day, he came, took the day off from work. I said it again, black people. My dad took the day off from work. You know what kind of pressure that is? All the other parents got their camera. Go on, Tommy, go on. My father, all right, let me see what's going on here. All right. All right, well, you're through to the final. It's just you, the little Polish boy, the little chubby Indian boy. So really and truly, there's only one place you can come. But you know what it is with a father? Father, they don't want to take no chances with their sons, with their male children. So you give them that little extra psychological boost, innit? That little extra psychological boost. Because you don't want to take chance that anything could happen. So you give them that little psychological boost. So he said to me, all right, come. We don't want to take no chance, car. You don't bet me partner money that you're going to win. Yeah, man, I'm cashing two hands for you. Jamaica, here we come. So where you don't know what? When you're running, yes? When you run and you hand them a... where you do? Just before you come to the finish line, you puff out your chest. No, it's not much of a chest, but puff it, same way still. Puff it, and when you cross the line, puff out your chest. And if you see you cross the line, and you're not the first one, keep running. Now my sons, even though they've got that black heritage, because they've been here for so long, they've picked up westernized European sports ethics. And I thought to myself, what have I done wrong? Because my sons used to win, and now they're not winning again. And I said to myself, as a black man, what have I done wrong? These little fragile children. Little fragile children there. What have I done wrong? Then I realized it's got nothing to do with me. It's to do with the teachers. Because they're telling our children this stupidness, isn't it?
It's not about winning. It's about taking part. No, it's not about winning anymore. It's about taking part.
That's why your football team, yeah? We've been taking part in the World Cup since 1966. And I never win a race. Well, it's
not about winning, it's about taking part.
And now my sons are doing that, man. And I have to try and give them a little bit of psychological, you know, black on black psychological input from a father's point of view. So I said to them, you know, it's important to win, man. But sometimes what happens is when you're oppressed by a certain society, yeah, when they look down on you, what you have to do, you have to beat them at their own sport to show them no matter what you do to us, physically, mentally, we can still rise up and be better than you at what you like. And that's why it's important to win. Well, my son will come here and say, yeah, but the fat kids still get the same chocolate medal, daddy. And he come last. So why am I busting my gut for the same chocolate medal? And I said to him, you know what, son? Sometimes in life, you've got to think beyond what it is for you, but you've got to think about that person who's special in your life, that person who brought you into this life, yeah? That person, yeah, who, no matter what, is always irreplaceable, but their spirit is always there for you. And he said, what? You want me to win it for mommy? And I said to him, yes, son, I want you to win it for mommy. But I knew as a black man in this country where there's so much subliminal messages to our children about how they're nothing, about black and black crime and how they're shit and how black males are public enemy number one, I knew I just had to give that little petition Jamaican push. And I said to him, yes, son, I want you to win it for mommy. Because if you don't win it for mommy, mommy dies. Yeah. Yes. Yeah, we've got to get deep with our children, man. Yeah, we've got to reverse the psychology on them and motivate them in ways which come like guerrilla warfare. Yeah, come sports day, the other children they're messing about. Not my son, my son is on the line. Say bang! Motivated, man. I love comedy. The reason why I love comedy is because a woman in my life showed me that no matter what happens to you, that you can always rise and smile. You know what I mean? She called me her son, S-U-N-S-O-N, her son. She said, no matter what happened to you in life, you must rise and shine because you're my son. Now at first I thought she couldn't spell son. Because according to her, she never had a good edemification. But I understand it, man. And I see the way how like my mum was with like the younger people in our family, because you know what, we're starting to lose it ourselves. Because I heard what Jeff was saying about the children, and how the children is out of order and out of hand, and it's true. And it's because we're allowing them to behave like that, because society is telling us that children got rights. And we now become European and telling, yeah, it's true, you know, the children never have right. You can't do to them like what our parents used to do to us. Yes, you can bust their head. You start back chat, you hold them in the throat and squeeze their scuff, their suffer. Squeeze the throat, that can't say, squeeze. The suffers, what you call? That's it, the throat, squeeze it. But I tell you, when you squeeze it, they can't say the word either. Squeeze it. So I leave you with this one, because it's beautiful the way I watch my mum deal with unruly children. You know, we get children like 2 and 3 talking about,
I don't want to go grandma's house. Grandma's house is boring, blood. Yeah. Now you don't understand, right? Grandma, right? Grandma ain't even got colour television, you know. She ain't got cable television. Her grandma television, yeah, it's not even flat screen, but I tell you what, from the back it's pregnant. And grandma television don't even have remote control, it just got 4 buttons. And when you push the buttons, it go ka-tsh, ka-tsh. And grandma tell me stand next to the TV so she can get channel 5. I'm not going grandma's house. She ain't got Cartoon Network.
But my mum was a master of dealing with people, with the culture, the Caribbean African culture. Because number one, what she says, you don't stand over the child looking down on the child. That's intimidating. You don't do that. It's just a child. Bring your adult self down to the child height and gently whisper in the child ear.
You know why I'm going grandma's house? Eh?
And that
eh?
Is an audible warning. letting that child now know that now is a good time to change your mind. Before I change it for you. And if they don't heed the warning, she take the ear that she whispering, twist it and lift up the child to big people eyes. Yeah, me no have no cable television in my house. Come. And she take them in the front room, that room where nobody go. She draw the curtains. And she say, yes, we don't have no cable television inside here, but you know what? You look through that curtain there, you see sky. You see that cloud and that cloud? That's what we call Sky Plus. Now you can watch as much as you want, as much as you want, because in this house, that's what we call free view. Yeah, man. Yeah, man. I'm going to leave you with not so much comedy, but a thing where I want to say, you know, big respect to the Felix Dexter Foundation. Not a lot of people know that Felix Dexter was the first comedian who gave me personal time when I saw him in Selfridges, which was one of his favorite stores and one of my favorite stores. And I spoke to him about my passion for comedy, my love for comedy, and the fact that he was one of my biggest heroes, watching him on TV, and really wanted me to become a comedian. And he spent 30 minutes plus with me in Selfridges, talking to me about why I should do it, and the joy that he got from doing comedy. And I've met a lot of big people in my life, big stars, from Muhammad Ali, you know, et cetera, et cetera. And I was starstruck by the time and the generosity that he showed me. And at the time I was unemployed, and I had one £10 note in my pocket. And I didn't want a scrap piece of paper for him to sign his name on. And I took out that last £10 note and I gave it to him. I said, can you please give me your autograph? And he wrote on it, to Mr. C, big up, enough respect, love Felix Dexter. One love, Felix Dexter. And I kept that £10 note for, let me see, this was, I've been doing comedy 18 years, so I kept that note for at least 20 days before. I told you I was broke. On a serious note, I dedicate this performance to Felix Dexter, forever in our hearts, forever in our laughter, and my mother who passed away on Tuesday. And because of Felix, I wouldn't miss this for the world, you know. I hear my mother's laughter in each and single one of your laughter, yeah? Live, love, laugh. Mrs. C, bless.
Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for Mr. C.
Wonderful. Wonderful.
Absolutely. Thank you. Thank you. I know some of you men are getting seen before and wondering what the hell is that up there. I know some of you looking at me and thinking, I'm a blood club. I just want to tell you this.
Just look at your signature, sir. Nobody take it to sir. You understand? I'm in a run for boss of a boy in a frock. We keep on a boy in a frock, you know, no problem. It's just a hack. Jamaicans know it's a hack.
To everybody else, hack. Right? All right, clear that up. Now, Jeff was talking about Halloween and things. My man, Winston Anthony Brown, is from Jamaica. I love him like Kung Fu, really do. You know, Halloween's coming up. And I said to Winston, you know Halloween coming up, Winston?
No.
I said, Halloween.
Hello.
I said, Halloween.
How about that?
I said, you know when the beginning dress up and stop here and come and lock your door and talk about chicken cheese?
Come on, not through the door. Not pan, make them come, not pan.
I said, you can't do that.
I'm going to pour water on their ass. But then
I said, you can't do that. I said, they don't have that in Jamaica.
Of what? Halloween in Jamaica, you must say, Mother Bombery. We don't have them things. If you say anybody just up like the people, we come to chop off their ass. They're lucky. But Halloween.
Ready now? Ready?
Okay. So, ladies and gentlemen.
It's all right, ladies and gentlemen.
Yes.
Are you ready for the next act? I can't hear you. Are you ready for the next act? Ladies and gentlemen, this young man I have worked with literally all over the world. You get in there, you get in there. If it was white people, I wouldn't have to do that. We try again. Ladies and gentlemen, I have worked with this young man all over the world.
Woo!
He's got a beautiful voice. Oh God, and I like when he sing in my ear.
You what?
In my ear. Yes, my ear. Beautiful walk, ladies and gentlemen. Do I need to say anything more? Just bring him on.
Yes, bring him on.
Oh gosh, ladies and gentlemen, please recognize for crazy. Philip Dexter in the house. Give it up for Donnie.
Come on.
Come on.
Slippy. How you doing? Well, good. Yeah, yeah, yeah. You know this one? I. Big people take.
Know about big people things. Yeah.
Woo. Woo. How you feeling out there? Yeah? So when I say Felix, you say Dexter. Felix. Felix. Yo.
So give me that grown up love. That grown and sexy love. So give me that grown up love. So come give me that grown up love. Can't get enough time love.
Can't get
enough time
love.
Can't get home right now.
Give me that
grown up
love.
Yeah, 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 yeah. Woo! Okay, okay, guys, that's just a little warm up. Just a little warm up to get us into the move, 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 move. Alright, we're gonna run this one. I've got two tracks to give you. The first one's called Feeling You. And it goes up like this, 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 this. Let me set. Turn up in here.
Girl, you make me wanna say, yeah, yeah.
Gee, I see you. Yo,
I'm feeling you, baby, yeah.
Gee.
I'm feeling you, baby, yeah, yeah.
Gee. Alright, yeah. Let me set. He goes.
Think you can do it all alone, guys. Feel like you wanna have somebody home, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. I see you listening to what I say.
Yeah. He goes.
I think I feel me, so don't walk away, no.
Why?
Cause there's too much chemistry in between you and me. Can't you feel the energy to give it a try? Think you want to move.
Yo,
then you go. Said you could never know how much you feel.
Yo.
Said I'm feeling you big time. Said this is more than a joke, right?
So baby, let's go.
Stop. Baby, let's go. Baby, let's go. So
yeah. Yo.
I'm feeling you, baby. Yeah, yeah.
Yo. Second verse.
Maybe I'm taking shots in the dark.
Woo.
Listen. Bow, bow, bow.
I hope one of them touch your heart, yeah.
Yo.
The saying goes, what will be, will be.
Yeah.
Think there's a chance for you and me, yeah.
Why?
Cause there's too much chemistry in between you and me. Can't you feel that energy? So give it a try, think you want to prove. Yeah, yeah, so then you won't know.
Yeah. Yo.
So girl, I'm feeling you big time. So this is more than a joke, right?
Yo.
So baby, let's go. I'm feeling you, baby. I'm feeling you, baby, yeah.
Yo. Make me wanna say.
Girl, you make me wanna say, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah. Woo!
I'm feeling it, baby, yeah. Girl, you make me wanna say, yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, 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 yeah.
Why?
Cause there's too much chemistry in between you and me. Can't you feel the energy, energy, baby?
Yo,
so if you don't try, then you won't know. We'll never know how much I'm feeling you.
Yo, listen.
Said, girl, I'm feeling you big time. Said, this is more than a joke, right? Yeah,
yeah.
Said, baby, let's go. I'm feeling you, darling. I've been watching you lately.
Yo,
said, girl, I'm feeling you, baby. Said, that you won't know. Feeling you, baby, baby, yeah, yeah. Come on,
so baby,
yeah, yeah,
baby, let's go.
Let's go.
Woo.
I'm feeling you, baby, yeah, 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 yeah.
Yo,
make me wanna say,
yo,
girl, you make me wanna say, yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm feeling it, baby, yeah.
Go on.
Girl, you make me wanna say, yeah, yeah.
Thank you. Yeah, yeah. Thank you. So yeah, I've got this ABBA tune. Oh, before we do it, have you heard of the British Collective? Some of you,
fantastic.
Do you know the British Collective? You need to get to know them.
Tell them, Don. Tell them.
That's it's featuring myself, Junior Giscombe, Omar, Lee John, Noel McCoy. The album's out now. You can buy it now. You download it right now on your phone if you want. Yeah. The British Collective.
Black people, they've got it already.
Oh, black. Oh, you got it ready. So one of you bought it and the rest of you burnt it, right?
That's what happened. Exactly what happened.
Lend me that CD, yeah? All right, so Selecki, let's take them back to 92 real quick.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
Bitch.
Oh.
If you know the words, sing along inside.
It's singing this one.
Sound my answerphone for 15
yeah,
years.
Yeah.
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 Make it a break.
Woo. Alright. Ghost.
She doesn't ever know why you love me so. In all of the things I wanted, you know why. Feel for you, you feel for me. It's all of the things we wanted to be.
And it feels so right.
Yes, it does, baby.
My
dear.
Yeah.
My dear.
Yo,
so many times, babe.
So many times.
Girl, I've been thinking.
I think to myself.
Yeah. Did I make my mind again?
I made up my mind
to keep my nerves strong and just
make it
unbreakable. Said, oh baby, you look at me once, look at me twice. Said, oh lady, those eyes are so nice. I can't wait to touch you right there. I know you want to touch me right here.
And it feels so right.
So, yeah, listen.
My dear. So many times
me.
I've been thinking.
I think to myself.
Maybe I
don't wanna be
with no one.
Yo,
sit and I'll make my mind. To keep my heart from falling,
just make it unbreakable.
Said I made my mind up.
I made up my mind
to keep my love from falling,
just make it unbreakable.
Yo, just make it unbreakable. Said don't you lonely, just leave me no doubt. 'Cause I really feel it's time. Don't you know you are the one for me? 'Cause pretty girl, you blow my mind. Don't you know this can't be no doubt? 'Cause I really feel it's time. Sexy girl, you are the one for me. Don't you know you blow my mind? So many times I've been thinking to myself,
I don't want to
be. Yo, said so that I made my mind up.
I made up my mind
to keep my heart strong, strong and
just make it unbreakable.
Yo, said so I made my mind up, yeah. To keep my love strong, strong, yeah.
Yo,
let's make it unbreakable.
Let me see some hands in the air, waving side to side. Yeah, lovely. Here goes.
Make it unbreakable.
Woo! Looking lovely, looking lovely. I see you. Here goes.
Make it unbreakable. There's no need to fool myself. I don't need no one else. I wanna just make it, baby.
Looking great. My name's Donnie. Much love, yeah? Enjoy the rest of the night. I ain't dancing with you, though.
Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Donnie!
I know Donnie from when he was little bit, and he's still little bit. Donnie, ladies and gentlemen, give it up one more time. Oh Lord.
You know he's Asian.
I know.
Oh, okay.
I know it's gone like a Jamaican. All the time. Did you enjoy that? We got this all night, ladies and gentlemen. We got people coming out here singing all kinds of songs. We got a lot of songs. Well, let me see, we got any young people in here? They don't even flip it well wait for me to ask how old the balling out. If your age between 10 and 20 makes a noise.
Is it how old? How old?
10 and 20. Why say young people in the balling out? I could have asked
you. Say that again.
Ask again. If you're between 10 and 20 makes a noise. Then it's all rap.
And they say black women don't lie. Bumbury.
Then it's all rap.
Yeah, I don't know. Wait, here's the best one. Ladies, and please, it doesn't remain to you, please remain silent. Please. If your hair is your own, make some noise. If your hair is your own at the root, make some noise.
Woo! And you know why? Because you get it stitching.
I can see the stitching from here. One woman shouting so loud, the stitching came out.
Lisa, look, she paid good money for it.
So ladies and gents, our next performer, well, I must say, quite jealous. I remember I was watching on television, I was watching the video one night, and they had some naked women dance in the video, and I thought,
oh yes.
Remember?
Yes.
I was like, wow.
I would like to sing.
Absolutely.
That's what you thought.
Absolutely.
Didn't work.
No, absolutely.
Thank God.
You won't believe we used to get out of each other. Don't touch me! Serious, don't touch me. People get your idea.
We used to go with each other when we used to dance. You know, he used to put me to the wall and dance. No one could see me back in the day.
You don't believe that, do you?
And if you ever see that, he got me up and down, up and down, up and down, like a fairground ride.
And I thought some of you out there were my friends. So ladies and gents, will you please put your hands together?
Hold on. Who are we bringing on now?
We're bringing on Ghetto.
Give it up, ladies and gentlemen!
The Wayne Marshall!
Hey, how you doing? Enough respect. Felix is not here, but he's here. And you know, the legacy will continue. Give me a track, man. This is a song. We've heard Obama talk about it. We've even heard Theresa May talk about it. I'm gonna do my little piece today. I was drawn by the river, like the Sam Cooke song, and like the river, blood keeps running in my hometown. It's been long time coming, but I know change gonna come. Oh yeah, it's been too hard to live it, but I'm on a natural high. Even though the cracks won't come there, stretching out the sky. It's been a long time coming. But I know, yes I know, change gon' come. Oh yeah. I took my girl to the movies, down the road from my crib. We get abuse from the postcode killer, who wants to murder me from where I. It's been a long time coming. But I know, yes I know, change is gonna come. You feel me? See that I'm close to my brother. Yeah. I say, brother, help me please. Yeah. If any winds up knocking me, yeah, down, back down, oh, my knees. It's been a long time coming. But I know, yes I know, change. Ooh, there's gonna be a breakthrough one day. So when I go to my brother, I say, hey, brother, help me please.
of knocking me lonely. Now I'm back down on. Her change is going through. Oh yes it will. Oh yes it will. Oh yes it will. Are you ready for a change? Say yeah, yeah. Say yeah, yeah. Are you
enough respect, Felix. Enough respect. This is a song I'm going to do for you that you have supported me for all this time. And enough respect to all my fans. Enough respect to all my friends. And enough respect to all of you here. Enough respect. Give it a rhythm. Feel free to sing along if you know the words. Even if you don't know the words, I'm sure you know the ooh and the ah.
Look into my eyes when we're dancing in the club. Run my hands down your thighs, baby, that is not enough. No, if you think I wanna take you home after the first
night,
all the things that's associated, you're damn right.
Come on, live.
Cause tonight I wanna hear you say. TSA. When I enter G-spot, baby, I wanna hear you moan and groan with delight. Oh yeah, so let me hear you say, TSA. Yeah, when I enter G-spot, baby, I wanna hear you moan and groan tonight. Oh yeah, for ecstasy. You don't have to go too far. Wherever she is in Hammersmith, I'm sure that we can find it in the dark. So hold back, relax, girl. I am ready for a bit. And if ecstasy is waiting, baby, I'm coming. Come when you say, when I hit your G-spot, baby, I wanna hear you moan and groan with delight. Baby, baby, let me hear you say, yeah. And when I hit your G-spot, baby, I wanna hear you moan and groan tonight, lady. To make you come alive.
Sing along.
Are you ready for me? To make you wet inside, girl. Yeah, yeah. To make you just sit on the floor. Cause baby, I got to let you know. I wanna hear you moan, come with delight, baby, say. Cause when I hit your G-spot, baby, I wanna hear you moan and groan and moan and groan. I wanna hear you moan and groan and moan.
Sing it. So let me hear you say. TSA. Cause when I hit your taste spider, baby, I wanna hear you moan and groan with delight. Sing along, so let me hear you sing. TSA. Yeah, when I hit your taste spider, baby, I wanna hear you moan and groan tonight. Nothing said. Every time.
Jesus Christ. You know, Mr. Marshall, I'm a preacher. I'm going to hide that. You know what I'm upset about? Is he's never told people how I wrote a tune for you. Shut up! I'm kidding. One more time, Wayne Marshall!
Wayne Marshall, ladies and gentlemen, give it up! I know that take a lot of you women back, ain't it? I know, get him on.
You know, do it.
One day, I'm gonna forget that tune. When he did that tune. See, fellas, if you're in those stages of a relationship, you must enjoy.
Really?
Any new couples in the house, among the new couples? Anybody been with their partner under 2 years? Make some noise.
Is he? You're lying. Where?
I didn't say over. I said under.
Under. Not over.
Under 2 years. Under a year. Make some noise.
You can't see that these people married and have problems and everything coming.
It has to be, didn't it? 6 months. Fellas, be warned. If you're in the early stages of a relationship, fellas, you must enjoy. If it's under 6 months, enjoy. Because when you absolutely make that big commitment to maybe like live together, spend the overnight time together, let me tell you something, you will see some things.
Like what, Jeff?
The first 6 months, I never heard about stocking for. I had no idea what stocking for. Every time I went to her yard, the hair was pristine, it was fantastic. And then one night, tomorrow, what? She put this thing on. I thought I was being robbed. She put this thing on for 6 months. Like the first 6 months, every night was. The minute she got the key. There's no worse than a black woman's sword and starts arguing with you and telling you it's you. I'm awake and I started to believe in myself. You're not talking about my feet, you're bloody sorry! Now someone's choking her to death.
First 6 months, ladies, when you're there with the man, he makes sure you smell good every day. Come home from a wave, shower.
Yes.
Nowadays, you don't have to do that. I had my white sheets. He gone raving and come home. Lie in my sheets. When I get up in the morning, I think something is dead in the toilet. Nasty. You stay there and cast away. You stay there and cast away. You see this thing then? When they put on the shorts and they think they look nice and the foot look like chicken foot.
Oh yeah?
When you see them toenails,
yo,
they think the eagle has landed.
Yo. I'm not taking that.
The Chinese woman turned around and said, I don't got them tonight.
Fellas, what about for us? When you first start dating them, and them little sexy niggas, and we walk past like this. After 2-3 months, and them big bombering shots. Big hole in the night. And we're walking past, watch it. You never had a pup for 6 months, watch it. Enough for us.
All right.
You know who you are.
Shut up.
All right. Don't get me upset here.
Right, ladies and gentlemen. The next young lady we bring on is a ladies' girl. Ladies,
and she loves to beat up the man then. And she's fantastic with it. One of the best performers on the comedy circuit.
Yes.
Ladies and gents, we make some noise for the dynamite, the dynamic, the beautiful, the wonderful, the chosen one.
Miss.
Make some noise for Donna Spence! Come on!
I was gonna say that, make some noise!
What's up, Hammersmith? How you doing? Brothers in the house, make some noise. Ooh, I like it. Ladies, let me hear you. Ooh, thank you, thank you, thank you. Ladies, can I have a 5 second silence for Angelina Jolie, who lost Brad Pitt to another woman? Oh, bitch! Serve her ass right. Couldn't that happen to a nicer person? If I was Jennifer, I would have been laughing my pants off. I'd be calling up like, hey, Ange, what's up? Oh, you sound like you'd be crying. You okay? Oh, you're hurting. Betrayed, bitch. Jennifer was too nice from the start. That should have been me. Because all you would have heard is, then sings my soul, thy savior come to me. Ashes to ashes, dust to dust. I don't play. I don't trust no woman with my man. When I get married, I'm going straight to the Caribbean. I'm not telling one last friend. They don't need to know. When I want to witness, drag two people off the beach. If my man's an electrician and my girlfriend calls up to ski, my house, the lights are gone out. Can you call your man over? No, bitch. Use one of them 70 candles you got until the morning time, yeah? Because I don't trust them crazy women. I don't trust them. Because, you know, coming up to Christmas now, ladies, it's coming up, and if you haven't got a man by the end of October, you ain't getting shit for Christmas. It's a wrap. I know. And some of us are going to go on holiday for the festive season. Yeah? We're going to go abroad, but ladies, can I just say, just because Rent-A-Dread bought me one ice cream from the plaza. Yeah? And takes you for a walk along the beach. Don't mean you're not giving citizenship to England. Yeah? What goes on holiday, stays on holiday. Yeah? Let it just stay right there. Because I know the sun will get to you. Because the sun does that. The sun makes you horny. Yeah, I'm a bit raw. Those who don't see me, I'm raw. The sun will make you a little bit horny. I don't know how it goes, because this summer, there was enough sunshine in the UK. And it was nice. And the brothers had me weak. I was looking at some of the brothers, I thought, oh my God, Lord, please don't let the flesh get weak. Because I saw some of them, I saw the chocolate skin and the muscles and the dip and the back. I was like, geez, Lord, please help me. And it's this part for me, ladies, you know that? You hear them? The obliques. Because I ain't seen my waistline for years. So I'm like, yo, what is that? Because I'm proud, I had my sunglasses on. You know what? When you're a mature woman, you can shout away all day long, it doesn't make a difference. I can feel that man on the street, no can't tell me shit. I just spoke to my granddad, I was like, yeah, it was me, and what? What are you gonna do? I'm glad I ain't 20 no more because I can do that shit. They look at me and my friends and go, and what? Okay, good. But there was this guy, I was talking to my friend, I had my glasses on, and I'm talking to him, and his brother passed me. And you know when the brother took my breath away? I was like, and you know what? She was talking to him, I was like, shut up. I went over to him, I watched him go into the store, top of his oyster, come out, I was like, hello, hello. Can I just tell you that you're hot? Can I take you out for dinner? I'm going to tell you, that was fine. I made sure he didn't come to that because I didn't want to see him. So where's my single ladies? You in the house tonight? Happy to be single? Chat rubbish. I don't know why we always act like we're glad to be single. Like we chose to be single. You know what I mean? Come on for work, turn the key in your door. No money here. Wardrobe full of clothes. Every week from Primark, every colour from Primark you can think of in it. But you're not pretty, you know? Matching curtains with a duvet and a steady. The steady candles must be beautiful. No matter what you have with. But hey, it's good to be single. Yeah, here to go into the choir. Brothers, where you at? Any single brothers in the house?
We're
going to
dance.
Yeah, yeah. That's what everybody's singing in the dance, the man then. Men never admit they're single because they don't know crazy woman to them. That's what it is. That's why they never admit that they're single. But you know the men I love is the old man then. The old men got skills, man. Old men know how to chat you up. Old men will chat you up if you don't even know how. Isn't it? Old men will chat you up. It's only at the age when they go, can I have your number? You're like, huh? But old men love a young girl. And that's cool, that's cool, that's cool. But they always depend on how young girls just want their money. Well, let's be real here. Let's just be real. Who got time to rub in the van with a DP? And put their false teeth in a glass of water with some surgery. And watch them play dominoes. Of course I want your money. You're lucky I don't ask for my name in your house. Please. Really? It's a crock them I can't take though, you know. Yeah, you know there's always a crock around, isn't it? Crock, ladies, if you've got a better shop in your area, you know crock convention is on. Hear me, yes? You can't walk past it without one of them trying to holler at you. Yeah, what are you saying? We say like you. Yeah, when you pass back, I'm going to talk to you. Talk to who? Know your class. I am not your class. Cross. They get on my last nerves. But the men that I miss is an old school Nigerian brothers. Yeah, man, back in the day. That's what I'm on your woman, isn't it? Remember back in the day? You see, men back in the day, they were confident. They could take us fiercely, woman. Because you know, men always say that black women are feisty. We were. I don't think we were feisty, but they were used to our kind of behavior. They knew that if we didn't want to hook, they knew from making them look smart, they were coming. Today's man, they want a backbone. They're frightened. If they chat to you and you say, I'm all right, they're going to fight you. But back in the day, and brothers back in the day, and nobody got cast out Nigerian brothers. Nigerian brothers got cast! Boo boo, your foot was right, they got cast! But they were confident. They didn't care how stiff their armpit was. How their foot dried that crocodile skin. They check you the same way. Psst, I think I've seen some way before. Confident! It's that ugly man, isn't it? Ugly man back in the day. They knew they were ugly. It's not a shock. They knew they were ugly. So they had to have some money. Today, ugly man will chat to you like, have you got any money though? And it's like they forgot they were ugly. They will say to you like, they forget they're ugly. Like, bro, did you know you're ugly? Really? And you ain't got no money. Huh? At least have some money. Be ugly, have some money. You can't be broke and ugly. Come on now. Back in the day when ugly man said to you, you could see you had money. You would spend it straight, you're like, all right, cool. Because you really couldn't bring that home to your mother, but she spent money and bought a couple of flowers. You're like, all right, man, let's see how it goes. You see, working nice. But ladies, you be in a rave. Let's go to back in the day. You be in a rave with your girls. All your girls are getting scrubbed. You want to have that grateful granny. With your flying saucer here, so with 100 pins. Praying that you don't sweat because you've got it pressed this morning. Little bun burns. With Vaseline just to keep it. Mr. Ugly's over there. He's seen you. You're like, oh no. Sana, sana, sana. Please don't put me to dance. Sana, sana, sana. I'm gonna make my foot burn in it. Sana, sana, sana. He's so close. Sana, sana, sana. And just as he gets close, and he's about to pull your arm, you think you're gonna go, no, all right, thanks. You smell the aftershave to be old spice and Fahrenheit, and you're like, I'm so sorry. My name's been Donna Spence. Thank you very much. Give generously to Felix Dexter Cherry. Good night. Bye-bye.
Ladies and gents, please, one more time for Donna Spence.
Of bringing on the most talented and one of the most talented vocalists of the last and the most recent generation. Will you please put your hands together for the one and only, the fantastic Aisha Lorraine!
Good evening, everybody. Thank you, Jeff. I feel very, very, very honored to be here tonight for such a great man, Felix Dexter. I'm going to sing two songs to you and I hope you enjoy it.
We think
and gentlemen, come on.
Fantastic.
Give it up one more time. Aisha Lorraine, ladies and gentlemen.
Hey, Bibi.
I see that
tune there, Louise Marks, was born just up the road in Shepherd Bush. Louise was one of the original genres of Love from Hero. And so that tune there, because she's no longer with us, she's up in heaven with Felix Dexter. Big shout out to Louise Marks.
Big shout. Sixth Street was Louisa Mark too, right? Sixth Street, you remember that too? If only you tell me.
Yes, sir.
Oh, but I
heard it.
Sing!
From.
Where you know? You know this. And you know what? And you know? Cut! And why the backside? You better go and bust her ass. Gone in tune back in the day, used to fool we. Back in the day, you remember how the man used to pull we for a dance? You remember just touch an elbow, a whisper. And you turn around because you won't come so flat and sat rub up with it. You remember that dance? They got social network and all type of thing. They got this Facebook, Snapchat. They got all these things here now to tell them where the rave is. Back in the day, we didn't have this site. We didn't have word of mouth. Word of mouth. All you need to know is this East London. That's all you need to know. And you drive up there. You didn't have to miss on the window thing. You had to wipe the glass. While you're driving, leave the window open in the car, right? You remember that? And when you reach up there, you don't know, all you know is the area. And the man they're talking about, shut up, your brother. Shut up, your brother. Why don't we leave now? We didn't need all that to shake them on. Back in the day, that's how we run things. But in them, the snap tap and all that thing, we didn't need that. Back, you remember, mobile phone. Back in that, they got mobile phone. You couldn't use the phone at home because that lock off. That lock off, you couldn't get that phone at all. And if you use it, you remember how you couldn't dial it quite locked. Hello? Hello? Police? No, no, wrong number. Those were the days. Love the days, man. You have to, if you meet someone in the dance, you tell them, there's my number. Ring me. 8 o'clock. Not 1 minute before or 1 minute after. But you had your own telephone, the public call box around the corner. You remember that? Ladies and gentlemen, you ready for the next act? We carrying on this thing. God bless Felix Dexter. This young lady, I have worked with her all over the world. Please, ladies and gentlemen, go crazy, go wild for Sandra Cross.
I'm still learning to walk in my heels. Here we go. How are you doing? It's so good to be here. I'm glad to be a part of the Felix Dexter fundraiser, and I hope it's successful tonight. It's just a pleasure to be a part of it. I'm going to take you down memory lane. Remember this one? Just sing along.
Yeah, I'm gonna make you love. Ooh. for.
Ladies and gents, the sexiest singer in Lovers Rock right now, Sasha Cross! Oh, God Almighty. Ladies and gents, our next act.
Phoenix had a very eclectic taste in music. And I remember when we were, I think it was in the fourth series of The Real Koi, when he really became, or became the superstar of the program. I went with him because he was doing a television pilot based on his Douglas, the barrister. And I was looking, flicking through his vinyl collection and came across this band. And he didn't necessarily know the band, but he loved them. So I heard this tune check up there, I was driving. This is one of the stations, as in community stations. He said, "Wicked, wicked." And when I told them, they were quite chuffed to know that they were a personal favourite of the late great Felix Dexter. And we're absolutely delighted to have some of the creme de la creme. Sort of say, the people at the back, they were seated here. Do you want to come sit there? Come take a seat. We just want to come take a seat. We're seated here. We don't really want people standing. Do you want to take a seat? You are uncomfortable. Come. But Jeff, you know, I'm not wicked no more because I've seen half the man.
I used to be wicked. Those who see me, they never see me before at all. Those in the back, I've seen you before.
Come on, please see me, brother. I want to ask you about your personal life. Last time you were in clinic, I want to ask you another major question again. Please see me, man. All right, that's happy enough.
Ladies and gents, will you please put your hands together and make some noise? They are absolutely wonderful. Put your hands together, go crazy. For the, start clapping from now, start clapping now, the administrators!
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. First of all, thank you, thank you, thank you. I'd just like to say thank you all for coming out tonight for a worthy cause for Phoenix Dexter. I'd also like to say thank you for Jeff Schumann and the guys for putting this event on.
It's a bit light here.
Alright, do you remember back in the day, remember administrators, you thought there was more of us, right? Yeah, some of us is missing, right? Can you spot the administrator in the house? Where's the rest of the administrators? Let me give you a clue. He's over there. What?
You're not coming up.
No. Alright, let's do that. We'll bring him on later. Mr. Schumann, come up quicker. Oh, my baby, let me tell you what's on my mind now. Oh, my baby, let me tell you what's on my mind. Move your sexy body, baby, move it next to mine. Remember the tune. Move your sexy body, baby. Move it on time. Hear me now. Can't worry about your mind and soul. All I want right now is your body. I know my style is cold, but I'm saying what I'm feeling. The time for romance gone. Let's loose it into passion. Walk my fingers over your body, baby. I say, oh baby, yeah. I'm gonna do you like I never did before. Hey, yeah. I tell you, my baby, move your sexy body, baby. Move it next to mine. Baby, prove it on time. Hear me now. Two bodies move as one. Let's touch and take control. We know the day is done, so let emotions flow. So baby, hang on tight. We're gonna tip to wonderland. my fingers over your body, baby. Yeah. Oh. Yeah. Woo! Remember that? Okay. Back in 1980, long time ago, administrators, there were more of us back then, we did a tune which went to quite successful. Many of you may have heard of it, and it's called She's My Lady. Ready?
Lady. When we lay down together at night, she holds me close in her loving arms. She whispers to me her words of charm. She's my lady, so divine. Her soft, sweet whisper is on my mind. She holds the key, unravel the mystery of a man like me. So she don't have eyes for the playboys, plastic smiles and the flat toys. All about chemistry.
Sing!
Well, yeah. Remember the day she walked into my life. She warmed my heart with as cold as ice. Now my love for her is burning with fire. She's my one and only desire. She's my lady and she's so divine. Vision of beauty and she's mine, oh mine. God's so crazy, oh, see her with me, oh yeah. The milk in my coffee, I know she's the sugar in my tea. Oh, eyes for no playboy, smiles and they flash toys. All about chemistry, love and eyes are history. Oh yeah, I'm in heaven when our bodies entwine. She fills my world with a sparkling smile. A Romeo and Juliet could never compare. In this heavy love affair. Baby, sing it to me. Now she don't have eyes for no playboy, smiles and a flash toy. It's all about chemistry. Love is all our history. Oh, I'm in heaven when our bodies entwine. She fills my world with a sparkling smile. Romeo and Juliet could never compare. Love affair. Hey, you search a million miles, you'll never find another.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much. You've been great. Thank you. Thank you. Enjoy the rest of your evening.
Give it up, ladies and gentlemen, administrators! Oh, Lord. Like, no, listen, we're running and moving on quickly. Are you ready for the next act? I said, are you ready for the next act? Please, ladies and gentlemen, I have worked with this young lady.
Hold on. Why are you shouting now? You're supposed to shout in unison. Look at her behind her head. Everybody, look, if you can see this over here, she's got on gray jacket and some funny hairstyle with funny looking locks, pink and longer, shouting out the time. We're black people, we're supposed to be unison. Right, ladies and gentlemen, I am wearing this young lady all over the world. Please, ladies and gentlemen, go crazy and go mad for the one and only Hilti Fox. Come on!
Hey! How you guys doing? You guys enjoying yourself? You sound like you are. So, yeah, we're here to honour Mr. Felix Dexter, and I'm really honoured to be here, to be part of this. So I'm going to sing a couple of songs for you, and the first one is called Strictly About Him. Thanks, Jeff, for inviting me.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
We love you, baby.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Come on and get real high till your head. this is the place to be. I'm going to do the next song, it's called Smile. I know that Jeff loves this song, so this is for you, Jeff, and of course you guys over here. And yeah, just go smile. And yeah, sing along if you know the chorus, feel free. Wave your hands if you want.
Let us stop and think a while. Walk instead of running a mile. Cause things are moving way too fast. Life ain't gonna last. Let us learn from nature. The seeds of life originator. The birds, the bees, and the trees. The seeds of life, our dreams. Cause that's the way I do things, yeah. Don't waste time with sad things. Ain't down with expectation, no deal. Cause I know what's real. What do you do?
I smile.
All I have to do.
Smile.
Yeah, and I seem to get through to you. Got all the answers I need.
No walking, just be me.
People say it's all insanity. While they themselves are saying, but if insanity is what feels good to me, I'm happy and there's no blame. People say I'm always singing. I smile at them cause it's joy is bringing. Cause contemplation is the key that helps me see. Cause that's the way I do. Don't waste time with sad things. Ain't down with expectation, no dear. Cause I know what's real.
I smile.
That's all I have to do.
I smile.
Yeah, I seem to get through to you.
I smile.
Got all the answers I need.
No talking, just be me. I smile.
For the superbly, the gorgeous core.
I'm not Serena.
She's in the car sleeping. Right, okay. Ladies and gents, just before we go to the break, we've got a very important speech from someone who not only knew Felix very well, but also gave many of us our big break on the comedy circuit.
Don't encourage it.
Sorry, I was just being your assistant.
Assistant.
That's what I said.
No, you didn't. You said assistant. Well, I don't know what you said.
Assistant.
He's also the vice chair of the Felix Dexter Foundation. And just to say, when you go to the break, we've got some tribute programs from the very first one that we did. It's got all the stars. They're only a pound outside. Felix Dexter t-shirts that you can sleep in. They're nice and warm. They're only a fiver. But every penny raised...
Every penny goes towards the foundation for us to build a theatre and an education centre in the tiny little island of St. Kitts.
You didn't have to say tiny little island. Just say St. Kitts.
I was thinking to myself, Felix was so big, this place is going to be massive. When you land at the airport, you will see Felix Dexter Education Centre. You know about it.
Absolutely.
That's how big we're looking to build this thing.
Next to Bradshaw at the airport, absolutely. So ladies and gents, will you please welcome onto the stage the Vice Chair of the Felix Dexter Foundation, one of the founders and the originators of the original Black Comedy Club. Will you please put your hands together for Mr. Ian Thompson!
I will get him, Jeff. You have to hold my hand so tight.
Oh dear. Okay. Mr. Thompson. We had a mic stand there. I don't know where it disappeared to.
Mic stand?
Okay.
Well, you ain't got no top.
Okay.
Thanks, Jeff. Thanks, guys. First of all, I want to give it up for Jeff Shoup, who's worked very hard to put this show together tonight, along with Debbie Rollins. Give them a big round of applause for the good job they're doing so far. Tonight, I'm not going to spend all evening eulogising about Felix. He was a dear friend of mine. And for me, he sadly passed on 2 years ago. And it's somebody who I still revere and miss. But he left us a legacy in which the Felix Dexter Foundation was founded in order to fulfill his dying wishes. But before I tell you what those wishes were, I just want to take you back just a little bit. Back to the time when I used to watch TV as a youngster growing up. My experience began with comedy to begin with Love Thy Neighbor, you remember that, Steptoe and Son, Till Death Us Do Part, all the situation comedy and stand-up comedians, including Tom O'Connor, Les Dawson, Tommy Cooper, and dare I say, the likes of Bernard Manning. Exactly. There were a few black British comedians on the rare occasion on TV. I don't know if you remember, Derek Griffiths, Gary Wilmore, Charlie Williams, Kenny Lynch. These were the pioneers of black comedy. Their brand of comedy at the time did not resonate with our own personal experiences as black people in Britain. We installed comedy from America with the likes of Bill Cosby and maybe considered to be a comic genius, Richard Pryor. That was it. And then Lenny Henry came along with his debut on New Faces. But he also worked in the mainly mainstream circuit, including working men's clubs, holiday camps and other venues not frequented by people of colour. And there was no platform for him to do so, and only his reach at the time was on television, and that was the only place we could see people like us, black comedians. But by then, the alternative comedy circuit had arrived, which still catered for the mainstream audiences, but with a different brand of comedy. Gone were the mother-in-law jokes, but it allowed new black comedians like Felix Dexter, Curtis Walker, Rudy Lickwood, Miles Crawford, Jefferson and Whitfield, Jess Schumann, and all the others that are here that you've seen today to learn their craft. We had to do something about that back in the day. And the first comedy club was founded in 1988 by myself and a friend of mine, David Bryan, at the then Brixton Village. I don't know if any of you remember it, Brixton Village, St. Matthew's meeting place. It was a community centre in the heart of Brixton. That first comedy club was hosted by Vaz Blackwood, And then the black audiences for the first time saw Miles Crawford, the Bamara Sisters, which then featured Angela Maher, Leo Muhammad, and Curtis Walker, who was then the headline. For the first time, black audiences could listen to comedy they could relate to their own life experiences. And the black comedy circuit had never looked back since then. Television executives took notice, and in turn, it spawned television programs such as No Problem, The Real McCoy, Get Up Stand Up, Blows and Skirts, The Crouches, and Chef. And Desmond's, of course, Jeff, thanks. Which all featured, for the first time, predominantly black cast and people that we could relate to. So ladies and gentlemen, I just want to remind you tonight, it is through the sheer will of people like Jeff Schumann. We have him in the house tonight, Keith Palmer, and he's now responsible, along with people like John Smith, Sarah Moore, for the continuation of black comedy, putting on comedians that you saw here on the stage, and many more I can go on to mention. And if it wasn't for these people carrying on what was begun back in the day in 1988, we wouldn't have what we have to now. And what's more important is that we've managed to reach this far with this legacy. Felix's wishes was that the foundation continued his work through his education initiatives and training, and to bring through the next young comedians or actors, doctors or accountants. The foundation is working with St. Kitts and St. Nevis High Commission here in London to set up education bursaries for families who wish for their children to go on to higher education, but also to build a performance space, as Jeff has already mentioned, in St. Kitts. Funds raised will go towards the social well-being of children with disabilities and in social care on the island. Jeff has already visited the island, along with Edna Ellidge, who's a member of the Felix Dexter family. She's here in the audience tonight. I'd like to give her a round of applause as well, please. And between them have already started the ball rolling. And you can visit the Felix Dexter Foundation page, where there's more information there for you. Here in the UK, the foundation will be working with organisations such as the ACLT, the African Caribbean Leukemia Trust, to further enhance and promote the awareness of bone marrow donation needed within the Afro-Caribbean community and to support the ACLT in their work. Felix unfortunately died from a bone marrow-related cancer, and as a foundation, we thought it a relevant cause to support, and I'm sure you all agree with that. We'll also be working with Keith Palmer and his comedy school to help young and up-and-coming comedians and actors to develop themselves, from stimulating personal creativity to encouraging social skills and improving literacy, and of course, learning comedic and writing skills. Bursaries will be awarded to the working, for us working with agencies and partners such as the BBC and the Arts Council and other similar agencies. I want to conclude by saying that the most important factor of the success of the rise of black comedy in the UK is due more importantly to you, the audience, and your continued support. So I want you to stand up and give yourselves a big round of applause, not only in support of this fundraising event, but also in appreciation for all the artists that you have seen so far tonight, and for those who are going to come on stage later, who have given generously their time to perform for such a worthy cause. I want us all to remember that we're here to empower ourselves. Let's continue to do so. Please give yourselves a round of applause, everyone. Thank you. Thank you very much. You're absolutely wonderful. On your feet, come on. Right. Some discipline now. Okay. Take a seat. Sit down, sit down, sit down. Discipline now. We're gonna break for 20 minutes, but wait. There's a guy at the back. Sorry, you don't like to sing anybody out. You know exactly what you want. There's a white guy in my eye line at the very back. Can see it. Hello, sir, how are you?
looking around. There you go, there you go, there you go, you're going to look alike. Come on, my brother. What's your name, sir? Huh? David.
Okay. David.
All right. Wait. David, I want you to do me a favor, Dave, because there's some people in here who are a little bit unruly. We're going to take a 20-minute break, David.
But Jeff.
No. I'm not arguing now.
I'm not arguing. Yeah, but Jeff, listen.
No.
David might be so entwined with the black culture.
No.
That he might come back later than them.
No. David, when you come back in 20 minutes' time, we're going to stop. When you come back, I know you're going to be here in about 4 minutes. You're not going to go, no, we're going to come straight back here. Lord, straight back. Yeah? When you come back, David, we're going to stop. Because some of them in here can't help themselves. This is the generation when they get sacked to be late, they blame it on racism. So, David, when you come back in 20 minutes' time, we're going to restart. In fact, David, you're going to be my marker. I want you to sit right there, David, when you come back. So we can warn these people. Ladies and
gentlemen,
make some noise for all the acts in the first half. Food and drink on sale. Go to the bathroom. We're back with Dennis Pavel. We're back with Janet Kay. We're back with Jefferson and Whitfield, the whole of the acts in the second half. We're back in 20. Thank you.